Good morning, ASD. Welcome back to the Falcon FlyBy. I'm Hamza.
And I'm Dorian. Thanks for tuning in. In today's show, we'll catch up with an award-winning app developer.
Spotlight Ms. Tredenick in our teacher feature.
Meet Payton, our new sports anchor.
Wait, one of our students is a certified yoga instructor?
Yep, and your picks of the week.
The FlyBy starts now. Dorian, stop playing with your phone. We're in the middle of a show.
Sorry, I was just checking out this new app developed by Albara.
Albara Jadella is a brilliant senior looking to major in mechanical engineering. Even after taking his classes in mobile app design, he pressed further to develop his coding skills and submitted one of his apps to MIT.
It was so good that MIT recognized it for the app of the month. Producers Safwan and Aahan bring us our story.
Albara Jadella, I'm a senior at ASD. My interests and hobbies mainly revolve around the STEM areas, so it's an educational app. It is meant to teach chemistry students about galvanic cells and their principles of operations. The galvanic cells are a very complicated topic because they involve different aspects of chemistry, and so that motivated me to create the app. I've been introduced to this platform through Ms. J's class, Intro to Mobile App Dev, and in that class she taught us the basics of how to use it, and from there I just started exploring the other components that weren't covered. So, and these components were mainly like storing data in different, like storing data in a server and then retrieving them. These components weren't covered, and I learned them on my own, and then I applied them to this project. So for young programmers, you know, I recommend just pushing through, because the first time whenever you script something, it's 20% is the scripting and 80% is the debugging. You have to keep looking over, testing, and testing continuously. You know, that perseverance is the most important part of programming. So right now, I'm actually working on learning Swift, because this one is only applicable to Android devices, whereas Swift is iOS devices. So I want my apps to be more universal. So after I learn Swift, I'm going to be making a few apps using Swift, also educational. And most likely also laboratory simulations.
Yoga is incredibly healthy for the mind, body, and soul. Even more incredible is Isabella Salman has been doing yoga for 10 years and just recently became a certified yoga instructor.
Producers Maya and Yusra stretched out the story. See what I did there?
I haven't been doing it long. I started in October, actually, so it's very recent. And then I did my hours, and then I became an instructor. Well, my mom became an instructor, and I honestly didn't like yoga before at all. I was more of like a track person, I was a hurdler, and I didn't like anything like that. And then I realized that I wanted to implement it with the stuff that I wanted to do later. And so I started it, and I ended up liking it. I practice maybe once a week or a few times a week, depending on how much work I have. To get certified, I had to complete 200 hours of training, and then I also had to complete 3 tests and also a written test. Now that I'm certified, I just want to continue practicing, and I want to try to find people to teach. To give classes and everything, and I'm going to be giving classes to the track team, and also later I can use it in college and stuff.
Speaking of health, in today's teacher feature, we bring to you a veteran health instructor and coach who works with both middle school and high school students.
Here's Maya, Teo, and Chris with the story.
Did you know that there is a teacher at ASD who not only teaches both middle and high school, but can also make incredible basketball trick shots? Today, we'll be talking to PE teacher, Ms. Tredenick. and finding out more about her. Tell us about yourself. Where'd you grow up?
I grew up in a small town in West Virginia called Follinsby. I have three older brothers, and my parents still live in the same house that we grew up in.
Why did you become a teacher?
As far as I can remember, I've always wanted to be a teacher. My mom kept a book K through 12, and every year I got to sign my name after each grade, and I put what I wanted to be. And from first grade on, I always put a teacher. My older brother, one of my older brothers, had a learning disability that he was in learning disability classes from kindergarten through 12th grade, and I just remember always enjoying helping him out and learning, and that's just what I always wanted to do, and I went for it.
World's greatest, same arm, same leg on the inside. Ladies, two hands on each side, step up, okay? Elbow goes on the inside, middle of the foot. Okay, here we go, first group, show them how to do it.
I think it's really important as a teacher and a coach. I think the most important thing is building relationships with my students and athletes, and just making sure that I'm establishing a classroom culture that the students feel comfortable and ultimately just feel comfortable to be at their best.
8 points! 8 points!
2 points! Well, what's 5 plus 3? All right, let's go,
Bree. What's one thing you love about teaching?
The biggest thing that I love about teaching is just seeing students being proud of themselves or when they accomplish something. What I liked most about teaching was seeing that light bulb go off or the kids really getting something, and I didn't know that that would be the same for PE. And I remember the first week into the job, I was like, I love this. It's really great to see kids learning things, being motivated, whether it be getting their fastest mile time or a student who may struggle with running but never gives up when they're running that mile. Those are the things that are really rewarding for me, and I love to see when kids are truly proud of themselves and they get something or accomplish something that maybe they didn't realize that they could.
Beyond your work at ASD, what do you like to do for fun?
So one thing that I do here in Dubai, I joined the Women's Basketball League over at for Ball Above All. And so many of, maybe your teachers here, but many of the women colleagues that I have here, we play every Sunday.
It's time for sports. Season 3 is well underway. We're happy to introduce Payton Andrews, our newest sports anchor.
Payton, grab the baton.
Dorian, that's not a baton. Hey guys, it's good to be on the team. Season 3 has 4 sports, badminton, softball, baseball, and track. Unfortunately, with this dark cloud of coronavirus hanging over our heads, all practices and games have been suspended until spring break. But I'd like to share some news about the track and field team with you. 36 boys and 33 girls make up the Falcon track and field team, the largest MESAC. It's a big team with big ambitions. We were able to get some statements from the coaches. Coach Baltez said, "We're more than a team, we're a track and field family." And Coach Wild said, "This year our athletes have started the season with a fire for competition and improvement that has raised both the level of training and attention to excellence among all athletes. I am really excited to see what they can do this year." Senior James Knight is one of our track athletes. He has an ambitious load competing in 7 events, including field, sprints, and relays. He slowed down long enough for me to catch an interview. Hey James, how are you?
I'm doing well, thank you.
So how did you get your start in track?
Well, in elementary school, the fastest kids were the most popular, so once I got to 6th grade, I wanted to continue that legacy, and that's why I started doing track and field.
And what events are you participating in this year?
I mean, long jump, triple jump, 100, 4x1, and shot put.
And which one of those is your favorite?
I think the long jump is my favorite, for sure.
And which one would you say that you're struggling with the most and why?
Definitely shot put, because I don't weigh 300 pounds and all of my competitors do.
And how do you think the team's doing so far this year?
We're getting MESAC gold for sure. I think this is the most well-balanced our team has ever been for track and field, for sure.
And is there a track athlete that you look up to or that inspires you?
Definitely Griffin Sturmer, who graduated a few years ago. He said stretching is for the weak, and I really connect with that.
Thank you, James.
Thank you.
Until the coronavirus has lifted, that's it in sports. Back to you guys in the studio.
In other news, we're sorry to report that our Harmonies for Hope concert and our Maker Faire scheduled for today have been canceled due to the health concerns of the coronavirus.
In a future show, we'll bring you an in-depth report on this issue. On a brighter note, next week begins our famous author visits, where famous authors visit us.
Also next week, parent-teacher conferences. So next Wednesday or Thursday, don't come to school, unless accompanied by a parent. And you know what that means, Dorian.
It's all good. We close today's show with our photo feed, recent snapshot of campus life against a catchy tune.
This week's tune was a favorite with our recent Pops concert. See how many notes it takes you to guess the tune.
From the crew at Studio F, enjoy the feed.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. I got it. You got this. Okay.
Okay.
Okay.